Hello and welcome, my friend. And next, I am planning to show you that how to replace this BMW's this timing chain. And now we have this engines, all engines, what are in 4 cylinders or 6 cylinders timing chains, and year models 2002 to 2018. Okay, and then this my first task is to take out this plastic cylinder head cover, and it opens so that I open firstly this oil cap hat, what is in here, and then I need to only remove that plastic cover out. And then next we can see in their electric cables, and there is idea that we have to open these ignition coils, these cables, and let's go to look at how it happens in here. An idea is that first I open the clip, and then these parts opens so easily. There is this clip. And then when these cables are free, I can lift up this my this ignition coil in that way, and there is this ignition coil. And I remove all of these my 4 or 6 ignition coils, and then we can continue. And there is now screws in these sides, and let's go to look what screws I mean. Like in here, there is side area, there is these screws, and now I have to open these all side screws in here, and also there are screws in that area. I am already removed those, and in here, and then when I take all of these screws away, we can continue, but let's look at how I open those bolts. Okay, and this bolt size is 10 mm, and there is my socket, and now I am using this electric drill machine because it is faster, and we can also use this standard wrench, and there is that specific bolt, look, and it works so that I open that, and then look, there is this elastic rubber in here, and sometimes this part is oil leak in BMW's cylinder head area. That if you notice in there any leak, then you should purchase these new bolts from BMW dealer. And now I remove all of these bolts, and then we can continue. Okay, and now when the cables are away and those ignition coils away, then it is easy to lift up that cylinder head cover away. And sometimes if this is stuck, we can insert some flathead screwdriver in this side, and we can bend that away. And this is really cylinder head cover, and it looks like that. Okay, cool. And now we can see this camshaft and valvetronic area in here. And now we can go to this next part. Okay, and then my next task is to go to open that timing chain, and let's go to look that area next. Okay, and then when I am planning to take out this timing chain, there is this interesting steps that how we take that out, this timing chain, and this replace starts show that firstly I have to go in that down area, and I have to actually take out next this oil sump. And let's go to look that what this oil sump looks like. Okay, and then my next task is to remove this oil sump, and here we can see this oil sump, and this oil sump is in locked by this engine block by huge amount, about 20 bolts, and for that opening I need now 10 mm socket And then let's go to look that bolt closer, how I open one of those bolts. And here is this our target bolt. And next we look that little bit closer and that what it looks like. Okay, and now we have good view. And then I insert this my socket and I open that bolt in this way. And there is really these bolts, they are the specific BMW's oil sump bolts, and they are very durable and also like 1 inch long bolts. And now I have to take these bolts away in all of that line in here. Look, now I have already take these bolts away, and there is huge amount of these bolts. Some are there left, but I have to remove now all of these bolts, and then when I have take those final bolts away, I can lift that oil sump next out. Okay, and then I need this flathead screwdriver, and I insert this my flathead screwdriver in these sides in that way. And let's look at how I little bit hit that. I insert this my screwdriver in this line, and then I hit that in here this way, and then this oil sump opens nicely, just like what we can see in there. And then I can lift that oil sump away in that way. And then there is also this connector what we can press in here and remove that oil measurement, this cable. Okay, now this oil sump is free, and then we can look this inner area, that is there any metallic particles, because if we can see in here any particles, then we have engine failure. But in that my case, this is free. Good. Okay, and then we can continue that job. Okay, and then my next task is to remove this flywheel puller wheel, and this actually, sorry, this is crankshaft puller wheel, and this is this big part in here. And there is really situation that when I need to take out this central bolt, and also in these bolts in here, especially the central bolt is extremely tight, and we have to in somehow use some hitting this impact driver that we can open that bolt, because this bolt is now in more than 300 newton meters force tight in here, and this bolt is really tight, and this is one of those issues when we are planning to replace this timing chain, that this bolt can be really difficult to open. And that's we have to insert some locking bolt in this flywheel area, in that area, or then we have to use this heating device what opens that by this heating ding 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 type. And now I have this my heating device, and I can open that bolt. But before of that, I need to open those three hexagonal tools that are in there, and I take my tool and I open first these three bolts. Okay, and next we need this hexagonal six corner tool what is in here. And this size is HW6, and this is like 6 millimeters, this hexagonal tool, and this tool fits in these bolts in here. And next I will show that how I open those bolts. Okay, and then I open those bolts, and now I am using this my heating driver, and in that way, and this bolt opens easily. And then next one, and it opens also, and then final one, Okay, good. And there are those bolts in my hand. And now when I move that little bit, this part is easy to remove. And there are those bolts in my hand. They look like that. And then there is this flywheel, what I have now removed. Okay, good. When these bolts are free, then I need to open that bolt. Okay, and then there is this my socket, and now we need this 22 millimeter socket, and there is this my socket, 22 is this size in here, and this socket, it fits in this central bolt, and then look, this is extremely tight bolt, and for that opening, I need now this my heating tool. It looks like that. And let's look that when I open that, and it opens nicely. And now there is a situation that this bolt is really long. And now I let this in this position, because when I am taking this timing chain out in there, it is good that this bolt keeps these wheels in that position. Because if I took that bolt away, then these wheels drop to ground. Okay, good. And then when this job is done, we can go to next job. Okay, and then when I am taking this timing chain away in here, I have to do in that BMW car, I have to open these small caps. They are like this, these caps in this engine block area, and I have to open these all these cap holes, because all of these cap hole. Now I will show one cap hole in here, what I'm meaning. That area, and in here that one. This is cap hole, and all of these caps, when I open that, there is one specific screw in those areas. And this is really interesting, because it is like some surprise in every of these bolts, like in there, that one. And when I open that bolt in here, there is some locking bolt in their inner area. And now I take my hexagonal tool that I can open this bolt, and I will show all of those bolts what I need to open. Look, there is first one, and now I use also this yellow painter, because this is the trick. This is first one, that hole in here. And then I have second hole, it is in that down area in here. Let's look that area, in this down area. There is my next bolt, what I have to open. It is in here, this one, and there is my cross. I have to open that, and then in here, that one, and then when we go in up, I have to take, yes, now there is one bolt was a little bit hidden, yes, sorry, one bolt was hidden in here, look, in that area, like in here, that bolt, and it is just in behind of that electric cable, very bad place, and now I saw that all bolts. That cap open, that cap, and that this one, and that one, and that one. 1, 2, 3, 4 bolts, what I need to open. Okay, and I will do those openings next. Okay, and then when I am opening these bolts, I need this hexagonal tool, what we can see in here. And it looks like that. And then there is this type is HV8, like 8 millimeter this length, and we need that kind of tools, and this bolt fits in here in that area. It is now in this area. We can see I open this bolt. I have already a little bit loosened that, and there is this cap hat, look, and it looks like there is this BMW's idea that they have installed that kind of cap hats, but I have to now remove using this my hexagonal tool in that way, and then I rotate this opens. And this is like first one, and then there is second one is in here in that position. Let's go to look that area, and I remove also that similar cap hat, and then next one it is in this down area in there, those two, and I open also that gap, and then that gap in here. Good. Okay, and now when these all cap hats are free, then I have next step to take these bolts out what are in their inner, and this is exciting story, because like in that hole in here, this hole, there is one bolt what can be like 10 millimeter or some Torx bolt, and we have to remove all of these bolts what are in their inner area next. Okay, and this is interesting adventure, because like in here I use now this Torx, this TX45 tool, look, it looks like that, and there was that kind of metallic bolt, and now I managed to take that out, and it was in that hole, and I had to remove all of these bolts what are in these four holes, and next in that hole in there let's look at what bolt is there. Okay, and now I have removed all of these bolts in these areas, and that means now that now this my timing chain, it is more loosened, these parts, and next I can take out this BMW's tensioner, and let's go to look that next. Okay, and then when I am taking out this tensioner, I need now socket, and now this socket size is this 27 millimeters. Here I have 27 millimeters, 27, and this bolt fits in here, and then I take my wrench, and there is then this my bolt also, there is this bolt what I am planning to open, and this bolt it looks like that, it is there, very nice bolt, and then this my 27 millimeter socket fits in there very nicely, and then I open that, and opening direction is in that way, and now I can rotate that using my hands, and there is really this interesting this tensioner and spring in there. And now I rotate and soon this part, look, there's quite big gap. Okay, and now this tensioner is so up, and we can look that it is very long bolt, and now I rotate that, and now this part opens, look, it is so big and interesting this bolt, and there is this part is this tensioner, and now when I compress we can see that how this tensioner, how it works when we look in that area in here, when I compress that my tensioner, there is really spring. There is inside in that area, there is metallic spring. And this is BMW's timing chain tensioner, and it looks like that. And there is oil goes inner area, and we can see that there is some oil holes in here, and there is some ABS. There's quite much burn out in here. Interesting. And that kind of part is this tensioner, what belongs in here. Okay, and then next part is to remove this Vanos systems, these solenoids and these valves what are in here, two of those. And for that opening, I need now this 10 millimeter socket, what looks like in here. And there is the first bolt, what I can open using that my wrench. And look, there is this 10 millimeter bolt, what I need to open in that area. And when I open this bolt, opening direction is in that way. Now I can rotate. Then this metallic part in here, this part opens, and now we can see that there is this nut and bolt in here. Bolt is in here in that area. We have that kind of part what keeps that solenoid, it pressed that in here. And then I like to take that solenoid out. There is idea that I had to little bit move that and pull out in same way. And then when I move that in this way, it nicely start to come out in that way. And then the solenoid is in my hand. Okay, good. And then there is similar solenoid in that down area. And I can also remove that bolt in here, and then this metallic plate is also free, and then I can also a little bit move that out, and it can be a little bit stuck, but when we do that small movement, look, a little bit move that in like up and down, and then pull out that all time in here, then it opens. But this is not open easily. Okay, and now it's free. Okay, good. And now these my solenoids, they are free, and then I can continue. Okay, and then my next step is to remove these camshafts, heads, and these Vanos wheels, and there is idea that now I have to open these bolts, and then I have to do in that step also really accurate markings that I remember that in what position these parts are, also in all markings what I need to do, because now when I open these wheels, they start to rotate, and then I have difficulties to take and install this back in same position. And in that step I also recommend that if you have this BMW's specific tool, we should to install that in position, because it keeps these parts better. But idea is now that when we have this our car in this TDC top dead center position, we have to make markings in here that we remember that in what position these all parts are and where. And now my next step is to open these camshafts, wheels, the central bolts, and we can also look these bolts closer and theorists that we can see that what they looks like. And now I open this exhaust bolt, and for that job I need now this 16 millimeter socket what fits in here. Now we can look also closer. Now we can see also that there is 16 in that socket. And now I open these both of those bolts, and I use now this my impact driver, because these bolts are also tight, and there is this tool, and now I open that. And now it's loosened good, and I keep that in position, and then I open that second one also. Okay, and now you notice that they rotate, and now I have to adjust this my position back, this in right position, because I have to remember that what is this my position. Okay, and then when I am sure that this now this my engine is in right position in that up area and also in that down area, in the crankshaft area, I can continue. And then my next step is to take these camshaft bolts out in that way. And now they are loosened. This is first bolt, and then this second bolt, what is in here, I remove also those. They are similar bolts. And then when I little bit move, I have to notice that these parts are loosened also. And then when I little bit move these parts, then these parts starts to move. And in that position, when we use little bit hammer carefully, I have in here hammer, and then I carefully hit that in this area and also in here. Then these parts, this wheel opens easily, like in here. Now this wheel is free. We can look closer. It is now movable, and then that one also some careful hits in that back area. Okay, now it's also free. Good. Okay. And now these heels, they are released, and then we can go to next part. Okay, and then my next step is to take this timing chain away in these wheels, and now when I move this little bit and tensioner is away, now I can take this timing chain away. And now we can look in there and we can see that now it's like loosened. And then I can remove these parts, these camshaft wheels, these parts in here, and I can actually remove this all package. And now little bit movement, and in that okay, and when I lift that little bit up, now this first wheel is free, and then also the second is free also. Okay, good, and it is in my hand. And there we can see those Vanos oil valves. Okay, and now in that same step, when this timing chain is movable, I can lift up now this timing chain's plastic rail, and in that position there are two of these. If you look in that area, we can see that there is those two dots in here, these dots, that and that. And that means that I can open now this timing chain in here, in that way, look. I a little bit bent that, and then I bent that little bit in this way, and then this timing chain opens. Okay, and now this part is free, and then the second part, it is in that way, and there is, then this my timing chain, and when I a little bit bend these parts in here, let's go to look closer. In that area in here, I can take, there is this opening, and now this part is free, and this is release, and then this my chain is also free. And now when I drop that in ground, it is in this ground area in there, speed. And next I have to go to work in this area in here. Okay, and then we can look a little bit closer at this timing chain rail, that how it works. There is this really, this rail, and in that area in here came this tensioner, and this tensioner press this area, this chains holder in here, and then tensioner chain moves in these rails, and when tensioner press this area, then this chain is tied. And then this is like this up area, and it goes in these two holes in here in that way, and now this part is like ready for reuse. And note that in these parts goes these bolts, what keeps this tensioner in position. And I mean now these cap holes where we had these bolts. And every hole in here means cap hole in here, and bolt goes through that area. Okay, good. Okay, and then when I am planning to remove and replace this timing chain, next I have to go to work in that crankshaft pulley bolt area, and I have to take that bolt out, and let's go to look that area next. Okay, and now we are looking in this my engine in down to up, and there is normally this oil sump area, and now this my area is this bolt, this crankshaft pulley wheel bolt. And when we look in that area, we can see in there this timing chain, it is in here. And then also the second chain, what goes in this oil pump. This is oil pump area in here, and there are balance shafts. This is balance axle, and they makes this engine rotation smooth. And now we can see that there is two chains, and they goes in that wheel in here, that wheel what is now in position two on by this big bolt. And now when I have loosened that bolt, we can look at how I take these chains away. Okay, and now when I am taking out this timing chain, next I have to open that big crankshaft puller wheel totally out, and now I rotate that, and this is really extremely important bolt, because now when I remove that, then these central wheels, they are loosened, remember that. And now I take this bolt out, and look, this is very critical part of this BMW engine. This is crankshaft puller wheel, what keeps both those timing chain wheels in position. And now I install this my bolt in here, it weights in here. And now these bolts, they are really loose, look. Now they looks like that they are in position in there, but they are actually loose in here. And let's look at how they moves. Then I a little bit move this my engine, and now I a little bit move that, and now I think that maybe I have to a little bit move this steel in here, that area in here. Now I have to carefully pull out that. Look, it came out. This part, and in same time when we look in here, this wheels moves also. Now I little bit pull that down, and then I can take my screwdriver. And there is then this my flathead screwdriver, and then I insert that in here, in this side, and I little bit bend that. I move these parts, and now I believe that these parts should open, and now it seems that they are not opening, and I think that why they are not opening. Okay, now it happens. Yes. Now this part goes out. Look. Now I can take this part out. And now, same time, when I pull this part away, those wheels are in this area. And now this my timing chain. It is in their ground. Ooh. There is then this timing chain. And now we can say that now timing chain is free. It is in there. And then also in here is this timing chain feel what goes in that direction. Look, in that way, in this way. And now when we are planning to install this back, we have to purchase first this new timing chain, and then we have to be sure that we install these all parts in same position back. And look, there is no any locking pins in that area. And these parts are only by lock, because there is this big bolt. Where is this force? 300 Newton meters. And it compress these fields. There is, by the way, second field in there. We can look in that inner area. And they are like together, that field also. They are compressed so hard that there is this friction. And then this joint is durable. But this is BMW engineering, and there was idea that how I can replace this my timing chain. And this back installation is just all steps reverse, and then be sure that this timing in this back area is in just in same T top dead center position, and then this camshaft area also. And then thumbs up, my friend, if you think that this is useful information to you.